So, tell me your name and what you're doing here.
My name is Maria Fernandez. I'm working as a program officer in WaterEd India. I'm based in Bhopal. I'm working for WASH, Water Hygiene and Sanitation. More focused on menstrual hygiene management, because I feel this is not only the issue of availability of facilities or sanitary napkins. It is the entire question of women rights, because menstrual hygiene management is linked directly with women's safety, dignity, health. And because of lack of sanitation facilities, because of improper management of menstruations, many women are facing different kind of health problems. I have met many of the adolescent girls at the age of 19, 20, even 25 years. They have to operate it and uterus has to be removed because of the unhygienic practices they are followed during the menstruation. So important is hygiene education, and more important is the comprehensive approach to deal with this menstrual hygiene management. It's not only question of the availability of facilities, but it is the more question about the how the women are managing their menstruation, how they are taking up this menstruation. They have to understand the biological process about the menstruation and should not only think about what are the cultural and religious taboos associated to it. If we can work dedicatedly on this entire things, considering the taboos, religious and cultural things, hygiene education, entire availability of sanitation facilities, and how we can reach out to the diverse kind of population, then we can really serve the purpose of this menstrual hygiene management.
So where will this education begin?
It has to begin right from the home, and because before attaining menarche, girl has to know about the menstruations. Many times girls are getting scared after suddenly getting the menarche. They were not aware about that, why this has happened, why suddenly blood started coming, why they had started bleeding. So that kind of information is not there with girls. So it has to be start right from the school and family. They has to be oriented before attaining menarche, so that they should understand why they have to menstruate, why it is important, and how they have to manage the menstruation.
Okay. And in which ways are religion posing a barrier for this kind of education?
Religion, yes, it's a major barrier in all the religions, whether it is Hindu, Muslim or Christian. There are certain limitations during the menstruation. You are not supposed to visit public places, you are not supposed to visit religious places. In Hindu custom traditions, many of the castes, girl has to sit at the corner. So the kind of stress and pressure the women and adults and girls are facing is really tremendous, and because of that other kind of issues are coming up. And this is entire question of the equity issues. Though it is biological, still why the indifferent treatment women have to face? So religion is playing major role.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.